Hello everyone, welcome to this session. I am Dipali Wadkar, working as an assistant professor at WIT Solapur. In this lecture, we are going to discuss the classification of the system, and this is the part 1. At the end of this session, student will be able to classify system. These are the content, signal and system definition. I will discuss examples of system, then the classification of system. In that, we are going to discuss continuous time and discrete time system, static and dynamic system. Before moving ahead, let us recall the signal. The signal is the function of one or more variables that conveys the information about some physical phenomena. Examples of signals are voltage, current, any XT signal, heartbeats, blood pressure, temperature. So there are number of examples of signals. These signals are one dimensional as well as two dimensional. System, it is the device or combination of devices which can operate on signals and produces corresponding response. This input to the system, it may be one or more than one. Okay, so this input is nothing but called as a excitation, and output from the system, it is generally called as a response. Okay, so in this example, XT or X of T, it is the input to this system, Y of T, it is the output from this system. Okay, practically this system can be represented as Y of T is equal to transpose of X of T. The one of the example of the system, it is nothing but CRO. Okay. So here the input to this CRO is provided through this function generator, which is f of t. Okay. Now this CRO, which is act here as a system and transforms this input from function generator into output in the form of image. Okay. And this image is displayed on the CRO. Okay. Here the output is, it is nothing but S of XY. Okay, and its independent variable for this output, it is space, and for the input, independent variable is nothing but time. Okay, so this is the one of the example of a system which transforms the input from the function generator into image on the CRO. Let us see the classification of the system. The first system is classified into continuous time and discrete time system, then static and dynamic, then causal and non-causal systems, linear and non-linear systems, time variant and time invariant systems, stable and unstable systems, invertible and non-invertible systems. Okay, so these are, this is nothing but classification of the system. System is a continuous time when its input and output signals are continuous time. Okay, so for this type of system, the input signal, suppose X of T, it is continuous, and Y of T is also continuous. Such systems are called as a continuous time system. Now let us see one of the example of continuous time system. Okay, so here the process of measuring the temperature of the room. Here the temperature monitoring system measures the temperature of this room continuously. So we can say that this system is a continuous time system. The another example of continuous time system, it is nothing but this RC series circuit. Okay, here Vs of T, it is the nothing but input voltage, Vc of T, output across the capacitor, output voltage across the capacitor. Now by using the Ohm's law, we can find the relation between the current and voltage across the capacitor, and the relationship of current and voltage for the capacitor, it is nothing but I of t is equal to C d dt Vc of t. Okay, so by using these two relation, we can find the relation between the input voltage and output voltage. Okay, so this circuit or this system is represented by using this equation. Okay, so this is the relation between the output voltage and input voltage. Okay, so input voltage is a input Vs of t, and output is voltage across this capacitor Vc of t. Okay, so this is the one of the example of continuous time system. Okay, so the voltage across this capacitor is varies according to the input voltage. Now, the next is a discrete time system. The system is a discrete time when its input and output signals are discrete. Okay. So, here for this system, x of n, it is in the form of discrete. Okay. So, output of this system is also in the form of discrete value. Okay. Let us see one example. In this example, the temperature monitoring system, which measures the temperature of the room only at particular interval of, the temperature is measured suppose at 1 o'clock, 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, like that. Okay, so for n value of 1, 2, 3, here the temperature values are given. Okay, so if the temperature is measured at a particular interval of time, then that system, temperature monitoring system, is called as a discrete time system. Then the static and dynamic system. The static system, it is the memory less if its output at any instant depend on the input at that instant, okay, but not on past and future values of input. Okay, so let us see the example of static system. Here y of t is equal to 2 into x of t. In this equation, put t is equal to 0, then the system output is y of 0 is equal to t into x of 0. Put t is equal to 1, the system output is y of 1 is equal to 2 into x of 1. Put t is equal to minus 1, the system output is y of minus 1 is equal to t 2 into x of minus 1. So, if you observe, the output only depend upon the value of present input, means x of t. Okay. So, hence, here the output is only depend upon the present input. Hence, this system is a memoryless or static. Let us see the another example for static system. Y of t is equal to t into x of t. So, put t is equal to 0 here, the system output y of 0 is equal to 0 into x of 0, which is equal to 0. If you put t is equal to 1, the system output is y of 1 is equal to 1 into x of 1, which is equal to x of 1. Put t is equal to minus 1, the system output is y of minus 1 is equal to minus 1 into x of minus 1, which is equal to minus x of minus 1. Okay. So, here again, the output only depend upon the present input. Okay, so hence the system is a memoryless or static. Okay, this is the third example. Y of n is equal to 9 into x of n. Here the output at nth instant, that means y of n depend on the input at nth instant. Okay, so we can say that this system is also static system. This is the example of discrete static system. Then the dynamic system, it is the system in which the output at any instant of time depends on input samples at the same time as well as the other time. Okay, so here the other time means this output is depend on present as well as past and future. Okay, so if such systems are there, the output may be depend on present, may be depend on past, or may be depend on future. So in that case, that systems are called as a dynamic systems. So let us see the example. Here y of t is equal to 2x of t plus 3x of t minus 3. Put t is equal to 0, the system output is y of 0 is equal to 2 into x of 0 plus x of 3 into x of t, here 0, so 0 minus 3 minus 3. Okay, put t is equal to 1 here, The system output is y of 1 is equal to 2 into x of 1 plus 3 into x of 1 minus 3, that is the minus 2. Then put t is equal to minus 1, the system output is y of minus 1 is equal to 2 into x of minus 1 plus 3 into x of minus 1 minus 3 means minus 4. Okay. So if you observe all these, here the output y of t is depend on present and past input. So this system is nothing but dynamic system. The another example for a discrete dynamic system, here y of n is equal to x of n plus 6 into x of n minus 2. Okay. So here the output at any nth instant depend on the input at nth instant. If we put the value of n is equal to 0, n is equal to 1 and so on, here the output at any nth instant is depends on input at nth instant as well as input at x minus 2 second instant. Okay. So it is depend upon the present as well as previous sample output. So this type of system is called as a dynamic systems. I will think on this one questions. Why the dynamic systems has a memory? Okay. So here, if you observe the input-output relation of dynamic system, here the output depends on past and future input sample. So we need a memory to store such sample. Okay. So this type of systems are required or has a memory. Okay. So the dynamic systems has a memory. So these are the references. Thank you.